Hello everyone and welcome to a short video about the new Pirate update. We got a new game mode and map, and the first thing I will show you is the new game mode. So what we got is a fireteam versus fireteam game mode, which is a 4v4, but with an interesting twist, because we have to capture a point and you see that a predator mask fills slowly up. What this means is that we get a hero basically for this game mode, which is the predator itself. So the team that has this mask filled up gets a predator for their team, which means fireteam and predator work together. However, this probably means as well that if we would lose the point and the other fireteam would manage to get the predator, we would have a fireteam versus fireteam and a predator versus predator fight, which could be very interesting. Which is also interesting is that all the gear and stuff is halved, which means instead of two healing sirens, we have only one, and the same goes for the predator as well. Instead of maybe five motion detectors, we have no, only two. But I think it's only in this game mode so far. And yeah, I'm currently waiting for the master of the lab to show you how it basically works. I will see if I can maybe record some gameplay of it. I don't know how stable the game is. Like I said, I don't really have much time currently on my hands and can't really play this game or record it, but I will try. So now we can accept and we will respawn as a predator. We can choose our loadout. By the way, we got more loadouts now. We can have 11 loadouts instead of, what was it before, 6. And you see, now I spawned as my alpha predator. And I will basically now be a hero unit for my team. Which means, if we would not be in an actual lobby, my teammates would now still be defending there and I would have the objective to help them. Obviously the team that got the predator first will have a big advantage. Just because a predator on your team is really powerful, because you have all the abilities from the normal hunt game mode for the predator. You have bear traps, you have all the other gear, you can basically take everything with you. And the only difference is that your gear is halved in this game mode. So, here, you can see everything is halved. If I would now have equipped large pouch, there would be more than just one siren, because usually you would have four, but in this game mode you would have two then, and I think you get the point. So this could be really cool, especially a predator versus predator fight. But now we will look at the new map again in the private match where we just will explore. I will make a video where I actually try to play on these maps and the new game mode sooner or later, maybe in the weekend. And yeah, so what's special about this map is that it's again a jungle. Obviously they will probably stick for the to the jungle team for some time, because that's basically what the game is about predators hunting humans in the jungle. And what's special about this map is, instead of being just a jungle, there are some caves, and there's actually a cave base. However, you will just get some overlooks, views on the area, and look at the camps. So the camps are not really special, but one. This is, I think, a slightly changed camp from the camps we normally have. It has some tents all around the place. It's just a basic building, not really something that much different from the buildings we have on the other maps. The only difference for these camps are the tents. Oh no. So yeah, nothing really special about it. Here will probably be a PC objective where you have to just interact with it and defend this point, and it will probably be the same like with every other map. I don't think that in this camps is something special. We have the medikit, laying around here and there. But yeah, the only thing new here are the tents and the cave system camp, which is very unique. And we will go to that. I think now, yeah, let's go to it. Here are some containers. You can go for the middle one. There's also something explosive, so you should watch out for a plasma blast coming to your direction when you're going through the tunnel. And yeah, it's just a jungle map with a few extra steps. Nothing that special, but still nice to have, because this game really needs some new stuff, because it gets boring over the time. Oh, here's a respawn radio. So we already know one spot. Alright. So, the cave system should be somewhere here in the middle. And it's there. There's one entrance, it has multiple entrances. Hello, pig. Yeah, actually some AI. Why weren't in the first camp AI? But it doesn't matter. So, let's get the AI quickly first. So we can explore in peace. And why did that one not die? Is that the objective? Yes, I think it's an objective for a fire team. Damn, here are many around. So I really think that most of the objectives for the fire team will be in this cave. Mostly because it's kinda the main thing of the map. It's directly in the center, and yeah, here's already one objective, which is basically a bounty. Kill this and this target, collect it and do some other stuff. So there's no really new unique objective here. What is that? What is that? Aphonic. I know you're lazy, but this is really low. What is this? So we got the alarms as well in the cave system. And the cave system is basically just some kind of old rune. And we have also water laying around. So you want to be careful with your cloak, because water will still damage your invisibility, and it's really bad. Can we interact with that actually? Yes, we can. The predator can interact with that. That's interesting. And it's dead. Okay. This is interesting. So this is basically a way to get out of the cave. And yeah, it's rather slow, so I don't know. I don't think anyone would use this feature a lot, because you're pretty vulnerable sitting in here. You can't really go anywhere, and it's rather slow, and I don't see anything up here, so why would you even go up here? I mean, it could be maybe a medikit or ammo box or maybe even a respawn radio, but I don't see much around here. I think this is only really a shortcut or something. So yeah, there's an ammo box, nice. That takes multiple hits. And yeah, I think this is the most special thing about the map, this weird elevator thing and the entire cave system here, which is rather long. I mean, you can eat that little pig. I'm interested if there's still this weird graphic bug where, oh hello there, AI, where there is just a triangle every time you eat the pig inside of the pig. That looks really weird. So what do we have here? That thing blinks, but I don't think that's an objective or something. Just decoration. And this cave definitely looks interesting. Should be rather easy to spot the fire team in here. And the same goes for the fire team by spotting the predator, because you don't really have somewhere to go in this cave. So you can't really hide in it. There's a lot of water around, so this will damage your cloak. This looks cool. So we have some kind of fossils swimming around. So far, I like the new map. It's again a rather big one, like Overgrowth, but it has a lot of details. I don't know how balanced this is, and I think this might be an objective. This looks kind of out of place, these C4s. And yes, we can see them in our thingy vision. So most objectives that has to be destroyed or something can be seen by the predator vision actually. And I guess this is some kind of objectives like deactivate the C4 or activate it even. I don't know. But yeah, there's not really much to it other than those areas. It's more walking around, there's not much to do in here, so this is slightly disappointing, but it still looks very interesting. We have also multiple entrances. We can go from over here, we can go from the elevator, even though that's a way that I would never probably go just because how slow the elevator is. It's more a point for the predator to jump in quickly, but for the fire team it's a pretty deadly way to go get to the cave because there are way too many entrances, so nobody would probably use that elevator because the predator can just sit here on a tree and just shoot down at you by you and stuck in the elevator, and if you jump down you probably die of falling damage, and if you don't jump down you will probably die by the plasma caster unless you're like a 200 HP support. And we have this little water area here. This could be a point for the exfil or a spawn. Interesting. Down the left was another entrance for the cave. Here's another tent. Here could be also an objective or respawn radio. There are some medikits and more of these fossils laying around. And we have all crates over the place, which are like before just filled with ammo boxes. Eventually. So yeah. The big at this camp. So where weren't we? Ah yes, we need to go to the camp down there. So this is kinda a bit more lazy camp again because it's more like the camps you already have, just slightly modified. Oh, I like this area. This looks cool. So the map looks pretty nice. Oh, hello there. I wonder, will they recognize that their friend is down? Nah, it's nothing. Probably just another bird. Yes, a bird with wrist blades that do less damage than a fireteam knife. Huh. That's sad. So as you can see, this is basically just a kinda copied area from all the other camps you have on like Overgrowth. And there's nothing really special to this camp. You will recognize the houses, it's just really copy-pasted. The only kinda new camp is the first one we were in, and obviously the cave system, which is more walking around than actually camp. There's just a few ladders and something, but nothing really special. It's not really a camp in the cave. So even though I like the map's design because it has some nice decorations, some nice details, and I like that, however, I think there is some wasted potential because they could have put so much new stuff in here and make the map a bit more interesting, but it's again kinda copy-pasted, so you will recognize these buildings. They're probably exactly the same but placed a bit differently with this little bridge. And yeah, can we go in here? Who's shooting at me? Show yourself. There you are. So that should be the last one. So yeah, those buildings are copy-pasted from other maps, so nothing special to them. Probably will have the same objectives like the other maps with just PC interactions and bombs and stuff. The only new thing I saw was the C4 down in the cave system, which is probably an objective for the fire team, but we will see when we play the game and play the map on both sides. So for matchmaking, the normal hunt game mode is pretty broken again for Predator. I saw 9 minutes 20 for Predator matchmaking and over 2 minutes for Fireteam, so I guess everyone is either playing the new game mode or everyone has just lost faith in the game and just left it as disordered. We got the Fireteam vs. Fireteam game mode before the probably multiple Predators vs. a big Fireteam. Which will probably come, because I can't really think of anything else they would do with a 15 player game mode. Because what else would they do? They could make a bigger version of the Fireteam game mode we already have, but why would they ever do that? That would be really stupid and a really big waste of potential. So here's some kind of staircase, and I guess here could be another radio and... Oh, we can go actually through here, it's not map end. Ah, so this will probably be the exfil point or a spawn point. Definitely, this looks way too good for just a random place. You would never go to this place. Is basically perfect for exfil point because water is around you. Have this little island, you can see the Predator basically coming towards you because of the water area where the Predator can't cloak. So my thoughts again summarized: I like the map's design and its decoration and stuff. It looks cool. However, a lot of wasted potential. The map is big and it has a lot of jungle, which is obvious that it has a lot of jungle, but the camps have nothing special to it. It feels just copy pasted, like this camp here, the cave camp. Okay, I know that you can't really make the biggest cave base, but maybe just some little bit more than that, because there was nothing more but decorations, nothing really to interact with other than the elevator, which will probably no one use because it is so slow and so easy to spot that you will be dead if you use that as a fire team. And why would the Predator use it? I mean, the Predator can interact with it, but why would he? So it's a nice feature to have, but I don't see a point in having it in this map, and that's the only special thing about it. I don't think that there are special objectives, because we already saw that when we killed that one really hard to kill guy, he dropped something. It is obviously something to pick up, and yeah. Nothing special, it's just the same objectives from all the other maps. And yeah, this was the new map. The new Fireteam vs. Fireteam game mode was okay executed. I would have liked a bit more than just one point on the map. However, what I really like is the idea of having a Predator on your side. This is really good. I like this. Because if it would have only been a plain Fireteam vs. Fireteam without anything special, I would have might even stopped playing the game at all. So, I will test out the new game mode, so that will be probably the new video. And we see you then. Have a nice day.